नमस्ते चिल्ड्रन, दिस लेसन इज फॉर क्लास सेवेंथ स्टेट सिलेबस स्टूडेंट्स। प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ इंटीजर्स। वन, प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ इंटीजर्स अंडर एडिशन, क्लोजर प्रॉपर्टी। लेट अस टेक टू इंटीजर्स 5 and 8 एंड लेट अस एड इट। 5 plus 8, 13. The sum, whatever we got, 13, is also an integer. Now let us take two integers, minus 10 and 2. Let us add them. What we get? We get 8. The sum is 8, which is an integer. So now let us take two integers, minus 3 and 0. And let us add it. We get the sum minus 3, which is an integer. Now let us take minus 6 and plus 6 and let us add. The sum we get 0, which is an integer. Let us take two minus numbers, minus 2 and minus 3. Let us add them. The sum will be minus 5, which is an integer. So from this we concluded that in general, for any two integers a and b, a plus b is also an integer, which is the closure property. Now let us check whether commutative property holds good for integers addition. So let us take two integers, 5 and minus 1. Let us add them. The sum will be minus 1. Now let us interchange their sequence. First let us take minus 6 and next we take 5 and then we add. The sum also we got minus 1. What is our conclusion? Our conclusion is, though we interchange the integers 5 and 6 and we add, the result will be same, minus 1. Now let us take two integers, minus 9 and plus 2, and let us add them. We get minus 7. Now let us interchange them. First let us take 2 and next let us take minus 9 and let us add it. What we get? The sum we get minus 7. That means though we interchange the integers minus 9 and 2, the result will be the same. Now let us take 2 minus numbers, minus 4 and minus 5, and let us add. The result will be minus 9. Let us interchange the numbers. Let us take minus 5 first and next minus 4. When we add, we get minus 9. That means though we interchange minus 4 and minus 5 and add, the result will be one and the same. So in general, for any two integers a and b, a plus b is equal to b plus a. So in under addition of integers, commutative property holds good. Now let us check whether the associative property for integers under addition holds good or not. Let us take three numbers, 2, 3 and 4. And let us take 2 and 3 as a group and add it. We get 5. For that, let us add 4. 5 plus 4, 9. Now what we do? Let us take 3 and 4 as a group and let us add it. The sum will be 7. And now let us add 2 to 7. Then we get 9. So, what is our conclusion? Our conclusion is, if we take 3 integers and add them in any manner, that means taking any 2 numbers as a group and adding the 3rd number, the result will be same. Now let us take one more example. Let us take minus 2, plus 3 and plus 5, 3 integers. First of all, let us take minus 2 and 3 as a group and add. The sum will be 1. To that, let us add 5. The sum will be 6. Now what we did? Now we have taken 3 and 5 as a group. The sum will be 8. So for that, let us add minus 2. The end result will be 6. So here also, the associative property holds good though we take minus 2, 3 and 5. Now let us take 3 numbers, minus 2, plus 3 and minus 5. First and add them, taking first minus 2 and plus 3 as a group. When we add minus 2 and plus 3, we get 1. For that, we have to add minus 5. So the end result will be minus 4. Now what we do? We take 3 and minus 5 as a group and for that we add minus 2. So when we take 3 and minus 5 as a group and add, we get minus 2. Minus 2 plus minus 2, we get minus 4. So here also, this property holds good. Now let us take another set of numbers, minus 2, minus 3 and minus 5. And let us add them, taking minus 2 and minus 3 as a group first. So when we add minus 2 and minus 3, we get minus 5. Further, let us add minus 5. So the answer will be minus 10. So now what we do? Let us take minus 3 and minus 5 as a group and let us add. The sum will be minus 8. For this, let us add minus 2. So the answer will be minus 10. So the integers follow the associative property under addition. In general, for any two integers A, B and C, A plus B plus C is equal to A plus B plus C. Let me repeat. In general, for any two integers A, B and C, A plus B plus C is equal to A plus B plus C. Additive identity. Carefully study the following. First, let us add 0 to minus 2. The result will be minus 2. Now, let us add 0 to 5. The result will be 5 only. Let us add 0 to 8. The result will be 8 only. Let us add 0 to minus 10. The result will be minus 10 only. Therefore, 0 is the additive identity for integers. In general, for any integer A, A plus 0 is equal to 0 plus a is equal to a. Additive inverse. Study the following. 3 plus minus 3 is equal to 0. 7 plus minus 7 is equal to 0. Minus 10 plus 10 is equal to 0. That means, in general, for any integer a, there exists an integer minus a, such that a plus minus a is equal to 0. Both the integers are called additive inverse of each other. Let me repeat. In general, for any integer a, there exists an integer minus a, such that a plus minus a is equal to 0. Both the integers are called additive inverse of each other. Now, let us see the properties of integers under multiplication. First, closure. Now, let us take two integers, 9 and 8, and let us multiply. The product will be 72, which is an integer. Now, let us take two integers, 10 and 0, and let us multiply. The product will be 0, which is an integer. Now, let us take two integers, minus 15 and 2. The product will be minus 30, which is an integer. Now, let us take minus 15 and 3. And the product will be minus 45, which is an integer. Now, let us take minus 11 and minus 8. And let us multiply. The product will be 88, which is an integer. Now, let us take 10 and 10 and multiply. The product will be 100, which is an integer. Now, let us take two integers, 5 and minus 3, and let us multiply. The product will be minus 15, which is an integer. So, what we concluded? In general, if a and b are two integers, a into b is also an integer. Let me repeat. In general, if a and b are two integers, a into b is also an integer. Now, let us check whether commutative property holds good in integers multiplication. Let us take two integers, 5 and minus 2. And let us multiply it. That means 5 into minus 2. The product will be 10. Now what we do? Let us take the same integers, but we change its sequence. First we take minus 2 and then we take 5 and let us take its product. Then also we get minus 10 only. That means 5 into minus 2 or minus 2 into 5, the product will be minus 10 only. Now, let us take another pair of integers, minus 3 and 6. Taking minus 3 first, let us multiply. The product will be minus 18. Now, by taking 6 first, let us take the product. 6 into minus 3. The product will be minus 18 only. That means, minus 3 into 6 or 6 into minus 3, the answer will be minus 18 only. Now, let us take another pair of numbers, integers, minus 20 and 10. First, let us take minus 20 and let us take 10 afterwards, and let us take the product. The product will be minus 200. Now let us change the sequence. First, let us take 10 and next minus 20 and check the product. The product will be minus 200 only. That means we concluded minus 20 into 10 or 10 into minus 20, the answer will be minus 200 only. Therefore, multiplication of integers follows the commutative property. Let me repeat. Therefore, multiplication of integers follows the commutative property. In general, any two integers a and b, a into b is equal to b into a. Now let us check whether associative property for integers multiplication holds good or not. Let us take three integers, 2, minus 3 and minus 4. First, let us take 2 and minus 3 as a group and multiply. We get minus 6. To this, let us multiply minus 4. The product we get 24. Now what we do? Let us group minus 3 and minus 4 together and let us multiply it. We get the product 12. To that, let us multiply 2. The answer we get 24. Then let us have another three integers, minus 5, 2 and 3. First, let us take minus 5 and 2 and multiply. We get minus 10. To this, let us multiply 3. We get the product minus 30. Now, let us take 2 and 3 as a group and multiply. We get the product 6. To this, let us multiply minus 5. The product we get 30. So what did we observe? We observed that the product of three integers does not depend upon the grouping of integers. Therefore, the multiplication of integers is associative. Let me repeat. The product of three integers does not depend upon the grouping of integers. Therefore, the multiplication of integers is associative. In general, for any integers a, b and c, a into b into c is equal to a into b into c. Now let us check whether in integers multiplication distributive property holds good or not. Check this. Minus 2 into 1 plus 3. That means we should add 3 and 1 first. The sum will be 4. To that, we have to multiply with minus 2. Minus 2 into 4 is minus 8. On our right hand side, we have minus 2 into 1 plus minus 2 into 3. That means what we did? We expanded that bracket 1 plus 3. So with each integer, we have to multiply by minus 2. So minus 2 into 1 is minus 2. Minus 2 into 3 is minus 6. When we add minus 2 and minus 6, the sum will be 8. What did we observe? We observed that left hand side is equal to right hand side. So now let us check this one. 1 into 3 plus minus 5. So what we have to do? First of all, we have to take the sum of 3 and minus 5. The sum of 3 and minus 5 is minus 2. We have to multiply this with minus 1. That means minus 1 into minus. Now, let us find the multiplication identity for integers. 2 into 1, 2. Minus 5 into 1, minus 5. Minus 3 into 1, minus 3. Thus, 1 is called the multiplicative identity for integers. In general, for any integer a, a into 1 is equal to 1 into a is equal to a. Now let us see the multiplication of any integer by 0. Minus 3 into 0 is equal to 0. 0 into minus 8 is equal to 0. 9 into 0 is equal to 0. This shows that the product of an integer and 0 is 0. Let me repeat. The product of an integer and 0 is 0. In general, for any integer a into 0 or 0 into a is equal to 0.